No, I was asking, like, you know, sometimes are you doing the sadhanas? I'm doing the sadhanas, so I see some progress, but I don't know whether I should continue to do the process, whether it's doing at the karma shuddhi, whatever, since I was initiated by the three masters, like the Art of Living, the Sudarshan Kriya by Guruji, and then Avadhut Shivanand Swami, I do the Durga Saptashati, the Bij Mantras. And So,
what is the question? Let's come to that question. Yeah. Make it question, summarize.
Yeah, the summarize is, I don't know, should I, you know, sometimes it takes long, not able to do, then I feel that I haven't done. And
Is the question clear to all of you?
Whether you should do it or not.
Okay, so now, what's your opinion? Your opinion.
If it is helping her, she can go ahead.
Okay. See, everything in the spiritual path is helpful. Okay? But finally, jnana alone can save you. Okay? So, antakkarana shuddhi means my mind has to be purified. Okay? But how long you will purify? How much you will purify? Is there an end to it? It's a bottomless pit. Okay? It is how many lifetimes, where, you don't know. It's a big ocean. So, you can spend many, many lifetimes purifying. It will give you good feeling. It will give a feel good factor. But, sometime you have to jump from purification to no mind. So, I am not the mind. If I am not the mind, why do you purify? You may do the purification, okay, continue to. I am saying, the problem is not the purity of the mind, problem is identification of the mind. What am I saying? The problem itself, mind, the problem is not purity or impurity of the mind. Mind is a mind anyway. Okay? So now, the problem is, I am the mind is the problem. I am the body is the problem. Okay? Now, no matter how hard you try in purification, I am the mind, I am the body will not go. Okay? That I am the mind, I am not the mind, I am not the body, I can only go through jnana. It's called shravana, manana, nididhyasa. And the process is called atma-vichara. Now, you have to, some point of time in your sadhana, you have to make a jump from purification to jnana. Okay. After you getting jnana, whether you continue purification, I don't know. But after you get jnana, I am not the body, I am not the mind. Like, you whatever is there in the mind, okay, fine. Let you want to purify, you purify. Right. So jnana is the final stage in your spiritual sadhana. Okay. So once you realize that I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect. What you do, I don't know. Whether you stop the sadhana or you continue the sadhana, I don't know. Very clear.
I was in that confused, you know, that.
See, I can only tell you your example of Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. Ramakrishna Paramahamsa was an intense devotee of Kali. He used to see her, he used to give naivedyam to her, prasadam, and he used to feel that she is taking it, the statue is beating. So, intense experience. But Todapuri gave him Atmadnana. Master called Todapuri. After that, everything stopped. Okay. So many of the practices which we do has an implicit assumption that I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. Okay. Once as it becomes very, very more and more clear to you, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, then whatever you are doing earlier, many of them will drop off. To the extent of Ramakrishna Paramahamsa saying, he used to do sannyavandanam in the evening, where he has to give offer the water to God. So it came to a point after he was established in jnana. He said, I am not even able to take water from the river and offer. The water just drops off. Means it becomes mostly, doesn't make much of a... sense, right? See, the problem of life, spiritual life, is to thinking that I am the body, I am the mind, I am the intellect. So with that, I am the body, I am the mind, intellect, as some lot of sadhanas are prescribed to people. Okay, these sadhanas will help them to improve the situation, purify the mind. It's called vasana. But nobody got realized after all vasanas are got cleared, because it's not possible. All vasanas are infinite number. Okay. At some point in sadhana, people make a jump from jump to Atmadarshana through Vedanta Shravana. Finally, they come to Atmavichara. Atmavichara is even beyond Vedanta Shravana. Now, here not no more listening to scriptures. There. You know, you are trying to understand exactly essence. In this class, you are trying to understand the essence, not the scripture as such. So, as it becomes more and more clear to you, I am not the body, I am not the mind, I am not the intellect, then a lot of things in your life changes. Then I won't say give a prescription, do this or don't do this. It'll up to you. Alright? In my life, I was doing Sandhyavana twice a day. Then I used to do pujas every day. At a certain point of time, all of them dropped. Even meditation dropped.
It dropped. So I wanted to know whether, you know.
Yeah, it is. So if you say that, should I drop? That means it cannot be dropped.
Yeah.
It gets dropped.
On its own.
On its own.
Yes.
Then it's fine. Right? So the question is, so should I do it or not? If it is there, you do it. A point will come, it just get dropped. Go, continue, further.
Yes.
So basically the effect I'm saying, this is my essence of my understanding. You are the light of the self, Atma Jyoti. So when I say, now you are thinking that you are the body or mind or intellect, you are awareness. Atma Jyoti means awareness, pure awareness. That I call it Atma Jyoti. So the class is about you are the light of the self, Atma Jyoti. The light of the self is light divine. It's called Brahma Jyoti. They are one and the same. One who realizes this becomes the light for the world, Jagat Jyoti. Light of love, light of peace, light of compassion, light of wisdom. The clarity will emerge. So this class is about this awareness. So I call my all my students as Atma Jyotis. You might be wondering, what is Atma Jyoti? Atma Jyoti means light of the self, which is awareness. It's not a physical light. So right now we have become a shadow of the self. The body, mind, intellect is nothing but shadow. It's not real. So you have to start recognizing when the foundation name is Light of the Self Foundation, which is Atma Jyoti Satsang, which is the light. I can't even call it inner light because there's no inner and outer there. Right? It is a pure light, awareness. So this, and you contemplate with the Atma Jyoti because that is the spiritual name. So gradually it sinks in. So what happens is in spiritual satsangs, people are given spiritual names. Okay, that's a way to contemplate on who am I. So in this class it's Atma Jyoti. Contemplate who are Atma Jyoti. So gradually it will become light of awareness, the inner light. So in this class, there are only three aspects. I am there, the world is there, there's the interaction, perception of the world. So we'll inquire deeply, who am I, kohamasmi, then what is this world, kim idam, okay, and what is my relationship, kim sambandham, between me and the world. And what is the right action? Kim kartavyam?
These are the four questions addressed in various ways in this class. We take the basis of Vedanta teachings, Pradnanam Brahma, Aham Brahmasmi, Tattvamasi, I am Atma Brahma. We'll try to understand in a very simple manner so that it's applicable to my life rather than getting into technical jargon, technical complexity, Sanskrit. We'll try to understand, grasp the essence of it. The focus is not learning something, focus is to get to the root, essence. Okay. So whenever, whatever I speak of, it should be digestible in this class. It's not that, oh, I'll remember something and go do something else. No. Grasp it. Then there is a saying, Brahma Satya, Jagan Nitya, Jiva Brahma Iva Napraha. The world is real, Brahman is real, world is unreal, and Jiva Brahma Iva Napraha. I am the Brahman. Okay, so this understanding also will try to get a clarity. And the process is the process of what you call as Vedanta teaching. Vedanta teachings are, these are the masters whom Ajja is here, whom I, these are the Ajja and Amutanamayi had deeply influenced my life. And my teachings are based on Ramana Maharshi and Atmadarshana. I don't know whether he is not very popular to you, but he is was a contemporary of Ramana Maharshi. He was a householder. He was a police officer in Kerala. He was in a high position, but even though he is a police officer, he was an enlightened being. He taught Vedanta to many students, Atmavichara to many students. There are many students from came from all over the world. He is actually, I would consider, as a very giant, a giant in Advaita Vedanta. And both of them, the commonality is, it's a vichara marga, inquiry process. Okay, so the Atmadarshana's contribution is, he made the inquiry process available to grahasthas, householders. Okay. This is Gaudapada Acharya. He is a guru of Shankaracharya's guru, Govinda Padacharya. Somewhere is an ancestor for our community. Very great grandfather. Shankaracharya, Advaita Vedanta. Putraja showed me the path of self-inquiry, Atmavichara. Amritanamayi, I had many, many occasions to get blessings of Amma, interact with her. And many times I've been called in ashram to give a talk and all those things. So the path is, see here, there's a, in the Vedanta, the path involves study, like Upanishad study and all. That I call as Jnana Yoga, where you have to study many scriptures. But when it comes to Ramana Maharshi, entire study is summarized in one word, I.
Who am I?
Just one word, I. The entire scriptures are summarized in one word, I. Okay, so inquire into I and you understand Vedanta. So that's called Vichara Marga. It's next step of Jnana Marga. So what you are doing right now, Vedanta study, and that is called Jnana Marga. So beyond that, they say Vichara Marga. Now, can anybody come to Vichara Marga? Not sure. Okay. It is, as Ramana Maharshi says, it's only very, very ripe souls can come to Vichara Marga. And beyond Vichara Marga, is there something? No. Over. So end of Jnana Marga is Vichara Marga. End of Vichara Marga is over. Nothing is there. That's all. So this class is about Vichara Marga. Okay. So all your, what do you call, it's a dead end. After that, nothing is there. You have to jump for all. So typically I'll make this into sort of a set of prakriyas or small processes. Okay, let us do some practice now. Any questions are there so far? Is there anything you want me to cover?
So I'll in this whole class I'll teach only two practices. I won't say call it as a practice, it's a sort of natural process. Only two. Okay. So that is the one is called Soham Dhyana, another is called Sahaja Samadhi or Koham Dhyana. Sahaja Samadhi or Koham Dhyana. Okay. Sahaja Samadhi is also called Sahaja Samadhi. One is called Soham and other is called Koham. One is assertion and other is inquiry. Okay. So now, have you done anything called Soham Dhyana so far? Meditation? What do you do?
That's a Sahaja Samadhi, which was a mantra given, which you, when the mind goes into the thought, you take that mantra.
Yeah.
And then it silences the mind.
Okay. So, this is also similar to that. Here what you have to do, first let us understand this, what you call as, Soham. What is Soham? What do you understand by Soham?
I am that.
What is that?
That light consciousness.
Yeah, where is that?
It's all everywhere. Not visible, but.
What is that?
Consciousness. You know, awareness.
What is that? Where is it? What matters to us is what is I am experiencing it, okay? The consciousness which I am experiencing is that. Right? So, pinch yourself, there is a consciousness. It is that only, nothing else. If everywhere that means, mind will go somewhere. Right? So, everything has to come to what we can understand. We cannot leave anything vague. So when you speak of that is this only. The consciousness in your body, pervading your body, is that only. Shiva only. Okay? So if that is not there, the body doesn't work. So that's actually consciousness, which is actually enlivening your body. And that is Shiva. Shiva is not very far off. So the moment you say everything, that means it will be somewhere. Oh, that means Shiva means somewhere. That means this pinch. Okay? Shiva is your consciousness, it's already there in the body. Right? Where is Shakti?
Shiva.
Also. Shiva Shakti. Where? I mean, no theory, practical.
In the body.
Huh?
The energy.
Okay, how?
Because whenever you say I, you point to the. Which is helping, functioning in the body.
All operations. Okay, all operations, all movement in consciousness is Shakti. The Shiva and Shakti are together. The Shiva is consciousness at rest, Shakti is consciousness in movement. Okay? Jiva is actually a confusion. It's mixing up something from the movement and consciousness. So Jiva has to recognize I am Shiva, which is I am consciousness. Okay? That's all his recognition. Now what is stopping the jiva recognizing consciousness is called impressions, vasanas. When you are a child, you are Shiva only. It's pure consciousness, child. Makru, children are called God, okay? They're not told to just, they are God. They are blissful. And they're simple, there's no thoughts, no memories, everything is simple. And the present moment. So the entire spirituality is how to stay in the present moment, like a child, nothing more. It's not achieving something. There's no achievement possible. Right? So one day I achieved something, no. So it's a recognition. And in the recognition, mind becomes silent, stay in that silence. Okay? So here you don't have to chant Soham. Okay? So now when you take the breath, just observe the breath. There is a sound which comes, right? Okay? What is this sound? This is called Soham. Okay? Soham or Shivoham means same thing. Shivoham means I am Shiva. And now the moment you say I am Shiva, you should not, mind should not go somewhere. I am Shiva means consciousness. Consciousness has two parts, visible part and invisible part. Visible part is there in the body, already you are experiencing it. Invisible part is everywhere, you can't experience it, it's unseen. So the visible part and invisible part. So this is consciousness. Okay, and movement is Shakti. Okay. Now in this consciousness, the nature of consciousness is silence. The consciousness is there, that's very silent and peaceful. The mind is only agitated, mind is the movement, Shakti. Okay. So the breath is naturally making sound Soham. You don't have to chant Soham. Okay. So the breath is already programmed to make the sound Soham. Then what you have to do?
Wait, just observe the breath.
Just observe, and if the mind gets diverted, remember that breath is making sound. Don't you have to chant also. Breath is there to remind you, Shakti is there to remind you that you are Shiva. Soham. Right? So, just remember, breath is nothing but Soham. So then mind becomes silent. Okay? And in that silence, don't try to do anything, just be. Okay? So let us do first practice called Soham meditation. Let's switch off the light. Close your eyes. Sit in a comfortable posture, either in Chin Mudra, Dhyana Mudra, or cross your hands. Become aware of the belly movement. Okay? When the breath moves in, belly moves out. When the breath moves out, belly moves in. This is inward and outward movement of belly. Become aware of the belly movement. Belly has three types of movement you can recognize. One is outward movement, one is inward movement, and other is a pause. There are three movements: outward, inward, and pause. So there is a pause also. The outward movement of breath, outward movement of belly, is the inward movement of breath. Inward movement of breath is called prana. Outward movement of breath is called apana. The pause is beyond prana and apana. When there is a breath move, when the breath moves in, the body becomes alive. Body becomes alive because of the inward movement of breath, which means belly moves also outwards. When the breath moves outwards, the body dies momentarily. It's a death of the body momentarily when the breath moves out. So life and death, birth and death are happening constantly for the body because of the breath. Every minute, every time when you breathe in, birth is there, breathe out, death is there. And in between there is a pause. In that pause, there is neither birth nor death. In that pause, the consciousness, Sakshi, is only alone there. So become aware of inward movement, outward movement, and pause of the belly. If the mind gets diverted, just remember the sound of Soham made by the breath. I am Shiva, I am consciousness. Also be aware that what you are watching is a movement. The movement is appearing and disappearing in consciousness. So you are, I am the pure consciousness, I am awareness, Shiva. In my awareness, there is a movement, Shakti. Inward movement, outward movement, and pause. I am silent, Shiva Swarupi. In that, the inward movement is called death, the outward movement is called birth, and pause is beyond birth and death, which is pure consciousness. I am the witness, Sakshi, beyond birth and death. Just watch the gentle movement.